हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू द चैनल। माय नेम इज मंजीत एंड टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द ऑस्कर्स। आज मैं तीन मूवीज़ के बारे में बात करूंगा। द फर्स्ट मूवी इज़ द मूवी दैट आई थिंक विल विन द ऑस्कर्स फॉर श्योर। द सेकंड मूवी इज़ द मूवी दैट आई रियली वांट टू विन एट द ऑस्कर्स दिस ईयर एंड द थर्ड मूवी इज़ द ब्लैक शीप मूवी। ब्लैक शीप मूवी एक ऐसी मूवी है जो किसी ने प्रेडिक्ट नहीं करी होती कि ऑस्कर जीत सकती है, बट समहाउ बीटिंग ऑल द ऑड्स दैट मूवी बिकम्स द अल्टीमेट विनर। बट बिफोर दैट समथिंग अबाउट द ऑस्कर्स। What differentiates Oscars from the rest of the film festival is the fact कि इसकी popularity non-movie watchers में भी बहुत है। There are literally thousands of critically appreciated film festivals and a lot of award shows, but those are famous within the film community. Oscars is an award that is famous outside the film community as well. जो लोग normally भी इतनी movies नहीं देखते हैं वो भी Oscars को follow करते हैं and chances of someone seeing the movie that has won the best picture at the Oscars is more than chances of a movie that has won at the Sundance or any other film festival, because it's the Oscars. They will read about it somewhere that this movie has won the award and they will ultimately watch it. So that is what I think differentiates Oscars from the rest of the film shows, that it has a popularity beyond the film going people. So the first movie that I think will definitely win at this year's Oscars is Chloe Zhao's Nomadland. It's a great movie, and by going with the stereotypical way that it has won the Golden Globe Award for the best picture, it has won the BAFTA for the best picture, I think ki sare odds isi direction point kar rahe hain ki Nomadland hi jeetegi sir best film ka Oscar. But there is a catch in that. Pichle saal the Golden Globe was given to 1917 and ultimately Oscar mein jeeti thi Parasite. And usse pehle I think the Golden Globe was given to Bohemian Rhapsody and ultimately the winner was Green Book. So that logic has a lot of fault in it. That is one of the reasons why Oscars are very unpredictable and always carry a surprise factor with them. You cannot really predict about the Oscars winner and they will always have a surprise factor with them. But इस साल ये सरप्राइज फैक्टर होने के चांस बहुत कम लग रहे हैं एंड गोइंग बाय द स्टीरियोटिपिकल वे आई थिंक Nomadland इज द मूवी दैट विल विन द बेस्ट पिक्चर एट दिस ईयर्स ऑस्कर। द सेकंड मूवी दैट आई वांट टू विन एट दिस ईयर्स ऑस्कर इज नन अदर देन ट्रायल ऑफ शिकागो 7। इट्स माई फेवरेट मूवी ऑफ द ईयर एंड आई थिंक कि मुझे उस लिस्ट में से जो सबसे ज़्यादा रेजोनेटिंग मूवी लगी वो यही मूवी थी एंड आई पर्टिकुलरली वॉन्ट दिस मूवी टू विन। देर इज ऑल्सो अनदर रीजन वाई आई वॉन्ट ट्रायल ऑफ शिकागो 7 टू विन एट दिस ईयर्स ऑस्कर, बिकॉज इट विल गिव a global popularity to this film, like the Parasite phenomenon. It's already distributed at Netflix and it's been distributed globally. A lot of people have watched it. But agar ek movie Oscar jeetti hai for best film, then even the non-movie person watch the movie. So a movie which carries a very important message reaches to non-movie persons and people who just randomly watch movies out of random curiosity with random ideologies, then I think it will kind of affect their thought process in a way. And that is why I think it's the most important movie of the year, which needs to be like plug in every time. The third movie that I think can act as a black sheep this year is The Father. ये एक ऐसी movie है जो basically एक पहले play था, but the director actually adapted it into a screenplay and made a movie out of it, and it is a great movie. It has one of the best performance of the year by Sir Anthony Hopkins, and he also recently won the BAFTA for Best Actor for this movie. I think कि मैं इस movie के बारे में ज़्यादा बता नहीं सकता because it will eventually defeat the purpose of the whole excitement and the build-up. I can tell you this much कि Hansel Mehta recently tweeted about this movie and he said that The Father is the mother of all movies. And one thing I can also tell about the movie is कि अगर आपने Ron Howard की A Beautiful Mind देखी है starring Russell Crowe, so you can actually kind of deduce the method used by both of the directors to display what is going with the protagonist. That is how I link both of the movies in some ways, and I can be completely wrong about this person analogy, but that is what I feel about these two movies. So to sum up, the first movie that I think will win at this year's Oscar is Nomadland. The movie that I want to win at this year's Oscars is Trial of Chicago 7, and the movie that can be proven as a black sheep is The Father. I always get confused between the time notations, that is IST or PST or in sabka difference. So to make sure that we are all on the same page, the Oscars are happening on 26th of April at 5:30 a.m. IST. So if you want me to predict about more categories like the best actor category, best screenplay and best actress category and do a video about it, then do tell me in the comment section below. And there is also one thing I'm planning about the Oscars. I hope we can execute it and pull this off. It's a very interesting community type of thing. I will be actually making a video and telling you in that announcement. So that was all for today's video. do make sure that you watch all these movies that have been nominated this year, and do share your experience after watching these movies. That was all for today. Until then, keep watching movies.